Hey, what's up? This is Dean from Futrell Autowerks. Today we have issued a challenge to one of the local chemical companies to kind of put up or shut up with their chemical carbon clean system. What prompted this was over the last couple of weeks, we've had two cars come in now that have had chemical carbon cleans performed and they were still exhibiting normal signs of buildup. Taking the manifold off the car to look at the valves is time consuming. It takes a couple of hours. In this case, we set some time aside. We work with these guys, good guys, in principle. And we pulled the car down, pulled the manifold, and did before video of what it looked like, ran all their system through the engine, and then took it back apart to recheck it. On a direct injected combustion motor, the fuel injectors are no longer in the intake manifold. They're actually below the intake valves in the cylinder head, and they do this so they can run higher compression ratios, higher fuel pressures, and it creates more horsepower, and it's also a more efficient motor. The downside of the injectors being below the valves is that you get this carbon buildup, and carbon is rock hard and it slowly bakes onto the valves over time. On a four-cylinder turbo motor, the normal recommended mileage that we're calling for our customers to do the carbon buildup, if we're not seeing severe signs before this, is about 70K. On some of the higher performance V8 motors, like the RS4, for example, carbon cleans are due pretty much about every 35,000 miles.
So let's get started.
So hyperextension test on the manifold. Looks pretty good, let them down. Looks more. Got pretty decent carbon buildup on the top side. Some of these.
There's some lighter on that one.
Oh yeah,
cylinder one is
really bad.
Cylinder one is the worst over here.
I see it on the back side.
Start off. So downwards of the valve is completely shut off. There's no fluid running through. Turned over that way is fully open. We're just going to do like a 45 degree angle to get the most.
Slowly let the engine get up to operating temperature as we're sending in there.
It looks like it's going down.
See the bubbles moving?
I'm going to step down there.
In the leaves, making sure we don't have any leaks down there.
Got that one, that one, that one, and now we're on this one, which is a heavier duty.
Yep, that's the heavy duty rinse down. Basically, we're rinsing down the cleaner that is hot soaked onto that.
Yep.
Onto that that system. So then we just do this, and then after we get done, we'll take everything apart, and he will we'll road test the vehicle.
Yep.
And
we're gonna put that, and then we're gonna put that last can through.
Yep,
after that's done.
Yeah, after we this cleaner was in there, the hot soap. Now this cleaner is clear and very potent smell. Mm-hmm. You can smell it. So. No, it's clear. Yeah, it's clear. That's what I knew because this cleaner is clear. Like, yeah.
holding the RPMs up is not going to hurt. That's going to help pull it in.
So we're doing a second can.
So throughout this process, the actual representative from the company was here. He was participating in the application of the cleaners, and we kind of let him guide through. There was a couple of times where he was having issues getting the fluid to push up through the lower charge pipe. So we ended up moving the feed up into where the intake air temp sensor goes into the manifold, just to make sure that we were being as fair as possible and getting as much of his fluids pumped through the motor as possible. As I issued this challenge to him, I mean, both Nick and I, Nick does all the carbon cleans. We were both, sure that this wasn't gonna work. And I say sure, I mean in the 99th percentile. It's like maybe we were gonna be surprised and we were gonna now have a new service to offer customers or a new way to clean the valves and potentially save them some money. Carbon cleans on four cylinder motors, probably anywhere in the country, will run anywhere between $600 and $1,000 for a proper intake manifold off, valve scraped. So as far as if you're wondering what this service costs, it's probably just under $1,000, and that's nationwide. I mean, our exact cost for something like this is about $750. We service the injectors at the same time. We like to do that because we're ultrasonically cleaning the carbon buildup out of the injectors as well, and also flow testing them. So what do you want to take away from this video? Well, you can't replace with a chemical what requires like a good old fashioned like hand cleaning. And we also use a walnut media to finalize the clean. You just can't get around that. If some other chemical company wanted to argue that, my challenge to them would be, we'll do it. You're gonna pay us, or I'm gonna pay you to comp all the time that we had to put into this to make it possible. Because I thought we'd be in a couple hours, and like I said, by the time we were all said and done, we had about 5.5-6 hours into the testing process, and that data was really something that we expected to be the final result. So we're pretty much just doing this for the sake of testing stuff, which we do like to do. We like to weigh stuff, we like to test stuff, and I'm not above accepting if there's a better way out there to be shown that way. So we wanted to give them the chance to show us that, which we did, and there's the results. It did not work. Stick with manual cleanings. If somebody is trying to sell you a carbon clean, make sure that they're willing to provide you before and after photos, and a very simple question you can ask them before agreeing to the procedure that they're going to offer is, are they going to use a chemical? Well, to what degree? And more importantly, are they going to remove the intake manifolds and manually clean the valves? That's truly what it takes. And this is something you're pretty much only going to need to do probably every 70,000 miles. So not a huge deal. Absolutely worth the performance benefits. Smoother cold starts, the engine's running smoother across the whole power band. You'll see better fuel economy from it. So we definitely recommend doing carbon cleans on the engines that it's applicable to it on. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the videos. We do things like this. We'll film some of the racing that we do, different exhaust sound clips, things like that. And that's what we're all about. Thanks.